So let me just be upfront with you about this pulse rifle. Amongst all archetypes of pulses, outside of maybe Graviton Lance, adaptive frame pulse rifles, time to kill-wise, are the worst. Unfortunately, Third Axiom falls within that category. But why in the hell, despite that, does this pulse rifle feel so good? And that's what we're gonna find out today. This pulse rifle just feels right. Now, first up, to get this pulse rifle, it drops from the Vanguard playlist. And although I have not extensively tested it, I'm almost certain that the Prosperity mod on your Ghost should affect drop rates. All right, even if it doesn't affect drop rates, like, just put it on. It at least makes us feel better. But let me tell you why this pulse rifle is so aggravating to get drops on, or at least God roll drops on, and that's because of its random rolls. Look at these things. You see how many options you have? It's the same scenario as bottom dollar and other weapons that are dropping the playlist. Don't get me wrong, I like loot, and I'm glad that there is more loot added to the core playlist. But just being upfront with you, it's gonna take a hot minute to lock a god roll, which is why we really don't have much variety in our rolls today, although I do have, well, a very good roll. Mine came with Hammerforge Rifling for that bump there in range, high caliber rounds, which was really nice, that increase in flinch. I know it's intrinsic on certain weapon archetypes, more specifically on aggressives, but it's not intrinsic here on adaptives. So this was a really nice added factor, considering that this weapon doesn't have a great TTK value. Anything that can possibly mess my opponent up is a big win, and high caliber was definitely doing that. It also comes with surplus for that increase in handling, reload speed, and stability. Now, I didn't know if this was necessarily gonna be required, considering that this is an adaptive frame pulse rifle to begin with. Take Bygones, for instance. Bygones, one of the best feeling pulse rifles in the game. It too was running into the same scenario where it was not in a competitive archetype. But Bygones being present in that adaptive archetype and just being an overall very consistent weapon, I never really needed to load out anything in its stability. Perk-wise, a lot of similarities, as you see here, between Bygones and Third Axiom. Range, stability, handling, reload speed. My God. The only difference is Third Axiom does have a little more aim assist, a little more in that default zoom, which is nice for that increase in range, and 74 recoil direction, which is almost vertical. I mean, I'm talking like a little bit of a sway there to the left, but not enough where I'm like, okay, you need to load out some recoil direction boosting perks or counterbalance mod. Not necessary, unless of course you want to overcommit to like Arrowhead Break. Now the final trait on this weapon for my particular role is opening shot. Improve accuracy and range on the opening shot of an attack. It's a really nice perk because it does max out that range and allows you to tag opponents for full damage. Probably the biggest benefit though is the increase there in the accuracy. Normally in situations where you have to just tag that first shot or set of shots on an enemy, opening shot like drags that reticle over to your target. And on some weapons, it is almost on the level of like auto aim. For this one though, I don't know if I was feeling the effects as aggressively as I felt it before. Like back in the day, Waking Vigil with opening shot, so good. Hawkmoon here recently, which can roll with opening shot. One of my favorite traits to include on Hawkmoon. And then of course, weapons like shotguns with opening shot for that boost there in range is why shotguns like Fellwinter's Lie and Astral Horizon can map you at crazy ranges. On Third Axiom though, was I feeling that level of like immediate auto-aiming potential? I don't really think so. Like I'm just kind of looking in that final column of random rolls. And even though I did like opening shots, again, wasn't necessary. Like looking in that final column, I think I would actually lean more toward multi-kill clip or rampage, and probably more so toward multi-kill clip, as multi-kill clip and surplus would be a fantastic combination. Now, it's really hard to complain about this weapon because realistically, this roll right here was shredding opponents. I mean, I was just chewing through people despite the TTK value being worse than most of the weapons I was dueling against. We've brought up other weapons that had great dueling capabilities. We've talked about things like Time Worn Spire, but Time Worn Spire has a 0.8 second TTK value. Sure, it's a good dueling weapon, but it has a TTK value that makes up for it. Third Axiom is completely depending on its ability to flinch the hell out of your opponent. And my God, was it doing that. Now, God roll wise for PvP, surplus multi-kill clip all day long. I think the weapon was pretty manageable all on its own. I didn't necessarily need opening shot for that increase in accuracy. But for PvP rolls, the toss-up for me, surplus, moving target, Zim moment, and maybe quick draw. Like I'm kind of throwing quick draw in there. But if I had to choose between quick draw and surplus, surplus all day long. And again, the perks to pair with it, multi-kill clip, rampage, is really going to be your best bet for PvP. And I even like rampage, considering the mag size. You can sit there and get one kill off and just start chaining kill after kill after kill in something like 6v6, you could see the potential. Now, I know we normally recommend like Headseeker, or we at least give it a chance. We're like, hey, Headseeker on this weapon, it has some potential. We've seen it before on high impacts. We're added a level of forgiveness where it allowed for 4 crits and 2 body instead of 5 crits and 1 body. The issue is adaptives, in my eyes, is already forgiving. 5 crits, 2 bodies, that's all that's necessary, and it's an adaptive archetype. Needless to say, I just don't think Headseeker is the play here on an adaptive. So overall, inside of PvP, guys, I really was impressed, and I'm kind of blown away, but not necessarily too much because I've seen the same thing before. I've seen Bygones compete. There was always like that one guy, right, that would sit on like the corner of the map with his Bygones and would just absolutely shred you. The one thing I think I would probably still choose though on Third Axiom, if you're looking to really get the most out of it for PvP, even though 74 recoil direction is okay, like it's vertical enough, if you were to include Arrowhead Break, that would make the weapon feel a lot better. It'll essentially allow this pulse rifle to have training wheels, allowing for every shot to be vertical. And there are other adaptives that I feel like are actually really good, like Last Perdition is one that's actually disgusting, specifically because of the rolls it can roll with, but as well as like the scopes, right? The Suro scopes really kicks that range out. Third Axiom, if you're looking to use it inside of PvP, I wouldn't necessarily overcommit to trying to get the most out of its range or the most out of its reaching capabilities, but instead just load everything out for consistency. And if you want to throw on some high caliber rounds again for some extra flinch, go right ahead. Now for PvE, this weapon's actually got some pretty decent reviews for PvE, probably due to the fact that 1, does arc damage, so you can pair it with things like Backrest. 2, though, considering all these combinations of traits, dude, there's so many ways you could take advantage of this weapon inside of PvE. Again, I don't think much changes in that first column outside of maybe including things like subsistence, but you know, feeding frenzy, surplus, subsistence, that's kind of what I would go with. But in that final column, whether it's multi-kill clip, whether it's rampage, whether it's one for all, thresh, dragonfly, or even just vorpal, there's so many damage dealing combinations on this pulse rifle. Again, you want to maximize synergy here, so you would probably want to go with things like feeding frenzy, surplus with multi-kill clip, and maybe something like rampage and subsistence. Now, you know we can't do a PvE review without bringing up, you guessed it, Disruption Break. All day long, Disruption Break saves lives in Grandmaster content. But man, what's amazing right here is the combination of Disruption Break and Genesis. I know. Essentially, upon breaking a Kaban shield, aka a barrier shield, boom, it should auto-reload the weapon from reserves. Now, in order to actually regenerate ammo from thin air, Genesis actually requires energy weapons to match the damage type to the combined shield. So you're not necessarily going to get that from, say, barrier champions. Of course, you will get that from enemies with arc shields. Regardless, though, that's a very interesting combination, right? Disruption Break, Genesis. It's like back in the day, I had a Ringing Nail, Disruption Break, and Shield Disorient. Deadly Man. Now, whether or not Genesis is the combo to go with for a Disruption Break roll, maybe not necessarily, because again, you're going to use your primary weapon elsewhere. You're not just going to use it for just breaking barrier champion shields. That's a very specific use, but I still bring it up because Disruption Break is so damn good. But Surplus Disruption Break may be the way to go there, or Feeding Frenzy Disruption Break. Overall, guys, your RNG to lock down a God Roll for this weapon, I've only gotten 2. Out of all the strikes I've played, I've only gotten 2. Your RNG is going to have to be legendary in order to get a God Roll. But with the right rolls, I really think this is a very good pulse rifle for PvP in the consistency department. Maybe not my favorite adaptive, but I was still very surprised at how well it handled. And then for PvE, there's just so much variety to choose from. So many different ways you can go with this weapon. So guys, good luck on the grind. Again, prosperity mods, even though some people have come out and were like, yo, they're not working, they don't work, I'm just gonna pretend they're working, okay? Like, what else would we be rocking in that final slot anyways, right? Increased loot is what we need. And for Third Axiom, you're gonna need every bit of help you can possibly get. Fellas and ladies, thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.